and welcome to the intensive care unit at the Royal Derby Hospital. We have put this short film together to help you understand a little bit about the intensive care unit and the people who work within it, and to give you an insight into what to expect during a patient's stay. We hope that you will find it useful and informative and would welcome any feedback. You are more than welcome to speak to any member of the team. My name is Sally Spencer and I have responsibility for the day-to-day running of the unit. If you are watching this film, it is likely that you are visiting a friend or a loved one who is either in intensive care or high dependency. I will be talking about some of the pertinent points to bear in mind with regard to the general layout of the unit, about the patient day and visiting, and about some of the key roles of some of the staff that you will meet whilst visiting intensive care. Firstly, it might be useful to explain to you the differences between being called an intensive care patient and high dependency patient. Our intensive care patients are generally those who require some help with their breathing and are attached to a ventilator to support this. These patients usually have a dedicated nurse to care for them. Our high dependency patients are those who can support their own breathing but require a higher level of intervention and care that can be provided by a general ward. One nurse will generally care for two of these patients. The intensive care unit itself is a large department, with the patient care area being split into two distinct areas. We call them side one and side two. In general, we aim to keep our intensive care patients on side one and our high dependency patients on side two. However, during busy spells, this isn't always possible. When our intensive care patient's condition improves, we will probably move them from a bay in side one to another in side two. This benefits the patient psychologically as they see a progression in their care. Along the bottom of the screen, you will see the visiting times for the unit. Visiting is restricted to two at a time at the bedside, unless agreed with the nurse in charge of that shift. We would ask that you arrange your visits within these timeframes, although we appreciate that there may be times and circumstances when visiting outside of these hours is necessary. This is arranged on an individual patient basis, and we would ask you to discuss this with the nurse in charge of the shift. The very nature of intensive care means that procedures and interventions are being undertaken throughout the day. We ask for and appreciate your patience if you are asked to take a seat in the waiting area until these are completed, before being allowed back into the unit to visit. Unfortunately, the wait can sometimes be lengthy, however the unit staff will always aim to ensure you are kept updated. Please also make the receptionist aware of your presence before entering the unit, as we are a large unit and consequently have other patients to consider. The reception desk is staffed during the daytime wherever possible. If there was no one available on reception when you visit, please can we ask that you speak to a member of the unit staff via the intercom before entering the unit. You will also see telephone numbers for the unit along the bottom of the screen. Please note that there are specific numbers for side one and side two. Infection control is an important issue to us. At various points around the unit, you will see the red alcohol foam dispensers. You can help in protecting your loved one from infection by using these to cleanse your hands when entering or leaving the unit. You will receive all of this information in the visitor's information booklet. If you do not already have a copy, please ask the receptionist for one. You will encounter many different healthcare personnel wearing a variety of different uniforms, and it may help at this point to explain who some of them are. Sisters and charge nurses wear navy blue uniforms. There is a team of six sisters and one charge nurse, one of whom will be shift coordinator and take charge of each shift. The shift coordinator's names and the consultants of the day's name will be displayed on the board in the waiting area should you wish to speak to them. In addition, all of the intensive care unit consultants, sisters and charge nurse photographs are displayed in the waiting area so that you can put a name to a face. All of our staff nurses wear royal blue uniforms. Our clinical support staff wear either green or grey. The housekeeper wears a maroon red shirt and black waistcoat. Nurse specialists and educators wear a blue and white striped uniform. Doctors either wear their own clothing or theatre scrubs. In addition to this, you may also see other members of the multidisciplinary team, such as the matron who wears a black uniform with red piping, pharmacist, physiotherapists, dietitians, occupational therapists, and speech and language therapists, who all have their own individual uniforms. The intensive care nursing team comprises nearly 100 individuals, but you can be assured that the nurses caring for your loved one will introduce themselves and be there for you too. If you have any queries or questions, do not hesitate to ask them. In addition, we have a team of support staff who look after the administration of the unit. This includes our receptionists, who wear a navy blue diamond pattern blouse, and the secretarial and audit staff. Any member of the intensive care team is more than happy to help you should you require it. I will now pass you on to Dr. James Lowe, one of our consultant anaesthetists who specialises in intensive care medicine.
Hello, my name is James Lowe and I'm the lead clinician for intensive care in Derby. I work with a team of 10 consultants who cover the intensive care unit day and night. When your relative is admitted to intensive care, there will always be an intensive care consultant that's in charge of their care. We have two consultants that are on the intensive care unit during the day and a nominated consultant who is always on call thereafter. They may be present on the intensive care unit or not, depending on what the requirements are. Our day is fairly structured to ensure that everything gets done that needs to be done. We start at 8 o'clock in the morning with a handover round where we're told about any problems that have occurred during the night, and we are informed about patients that have urgent problems that we need to sort out as a priority. Thereafter, we perform a ward round to see how patients are progressing and to determine a patient plan for the day. Once that is completed, then the junior doctors and the consultants will perform the routine tasks that need to be done for every patient every day on ICU. We have a board on the intensive care unit that has all the patients' names on it. You may find that your relative has moved around in the intensive care unit depending on their priority and what their needs are. So do not be surprised if your relative has moved around from day to day. In the relative's waiting room, you will see there's some photographs on the wall. Those photographs are of the intensive care consultants with their names. These are to ensure that you're aware of which consultant is looking after your relative on any day. We will always endeavour to try to speak to you as often as you would like to be spoken to about the condition of your relative. However, it must be taken into account that sometimes we have clinical priorities that mean that we have to dedicate more time to some patients than others. If you feel that you would like to speak to a consultant, all you need to do is ask the nurse and she will come and find us and we will come and talk to you with pleasure. We don't always say that we know the answers, but we'll always do our best to find them if we don't know them. Generally, having worries that we can help you with are better to be talked about with us than to let them bottle up inside. We're there to help you if we can help you.
Hello, my name's Barbara Day and this is Karen Gretrix, and we're members of the nursing team here on intensive care. We've been joined by one of our colleagues who's very kindly volunteered to play the part of a patient so that we can demonstrate to you some of the things that you may witness during a stay in intensive care. So Karen, could you tell us why patients might be admitted to intensive care?
Yes, there are a number of reasons why patients are admitted to us. Generally, they've had major surgery and need close monitoring and observation, and we're expecting them during the course of the day. Or there's those that come to us unexpectedly, either through having a serious accident, or their blood pressure becoming very low and needing close monitoring, or they're having difficulty with their breathing and needing help with that, or even that their kidneys are failing and we need to support their kidneys.
The equipment that you see in intensive care can seem quite frightening at first, as there's a lot of it displaying various different things. It might help us to understand what's going on if we can understand some of what this display means. So Karen, can you tell us a little about the equipment that we see around the bed space here?
Yes, every patient in intensive care will be attached to a monitor. The monitor will give us heart rate and rhythm. It'll monitor their blood pressure, it's a reading that we can understand, and also monitor their respiratory rate and their saturation levels. We may also have patients who require ventilatory support, so that is when they're breathing insufficiently and the ventilator is doing their breathing for them. And we also have pumps by the bed space, some to give infusions into veins in their necks or into their limbs. Others are to feed them through a tube that goes into their nose and down into their stomach.
Thank you, Karen. So with all this equipment around the bed space, is it all right to touch the patient?
Generally, yes. We ask that all visitors to intensive care wash their hands when they come in and before they leave, whether that's soap and water or with a hand gel. It's usually quite reassuring for the patient in the bed to know that there's somebody with them.
And what about nursing staff? Is it one nurse to one patient?
The aim is for one nurse to one patient if the patient is on a ventilator. Otherwise, if the patient's breathing for themselves, we generally have one nurse to two patients.
Okay, and are all patients in intensive care asleep?
No, they're not. Generally, the ones who are on the ventilators are the ones that we keep asleep so that we can control their breathing pattern. Otherwise, we give medication for pain relief, which makes people sleepy, but it's not to induce sleep.
So if the patient is sedated and appears to be asleep, how do you communicate with them? Can they hear you?
We presume that the patients can hear us, and we always speak to them normally as if they could hear us anyway. And also contact with the hands, the touching, is also a very good way of communicating.
Thank you. Karen, is there anything that visitors and relatives can help with the patient care?
They can help by generally talking to the patient, give them some orientation as to what's happening at home, and reality checks really, and what's going off in the big wide world. But they can help with brushing their hair, or help with cleaning the teeth if they haven't got a tube in the mouth, or washing hands. They just ask if they're interested in doing anything like that.
Thank you, Karen. So is there a daily routine in intensive care?
We try to stick to a routine for the day for the patients. Obviously there's bed baths generally in the morning. Physios come at 9 o'clock, 12 o'clock and 3 o'clock. Doctors do a ward round generally at the beginning of the morning, and then they'll come and assess the patients during the course of the day. And there's obviously turns to be done, investigations such as x-rays or ECGs. So although we do try to stick to a routine, it can be very varied.
Thank you. And it just seemed that patients in intensive care can be particularly vulnerable. So how do you protect them against the potential for infection and cross-contamination from other places?
To reduce the risk of infection in intensive care, we generally wash our hands every time before we go to our patient. Each patient has their own coloured aprons, and there's sets of gloves with those aprons. We'd have an ANTT for when we're giving medication so that we don't touch the key parts and introduce infection that way. The bed spaces are cleaned every day, and we encourage everybody that visits the department to wash their hands before and after leaving.
Thank you, Karen, that was very helpful. It can be very frightening to be told that your relative or friend is being admitted to intensive care, and it's very important to make sure that you look after yourself as well. Making sure that you eat properly and sleep properly can help you to understand the information that's being given to you, and thereby help you to help your loved one recover from their stay in intensive care. We will endeavour to make sure that we communicate with you effectively and quickly and efficiently all the information that you might need, and rest assured that your loved one is in safe hands while they're in intensive care.
Thank you for taking the time to watch this short film. We hope that it has been useful in answering some of the questions that you may have. If you have any questions now, please see the reception staff at the desk.